Hello students, my name is Sagar Pandya and welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today we are going to start with a very interesting chapter of our syllabus, that is chapter number 12, one of the most interesting and one of the most beautiful chapter of our syllabus, that is chapter number 12, India Transformed Part 2. Let's begin. Alright. Starting with this chapter, chapter number 12, India Transformed Part 2. So the first question arises, sir, what is going to come in this particular chapter? Matlab, India Transformed 1 mein hum logon ne bahut sara aisa cheez padha tha that we have already been through. Like for example, we have seen RTI, Right to Information Act. We had seen different movements. We had seen what is the meaning of the citizen or what is the definition of information. In this particular chapter, we are going to learn about different factors. Like for example, in society, that is in the social domain, what are the changes that are coming across? That is with respect to health, with respect to environment, with respect to education. And in this particular part also, we are going to learn some interesting facts about sports. Lovely. And also cultural heritage, of course. So agar aap 10th standard state board se pad chuke ho to usme aapko ye cheez already aapne dekha rahega, that is related to the cultural heritage and the monuments that we had studied in the history chapter of 10th standard third chapter, I guess applied history, right? So usme hum logo ne ye cheez padha tha. Let's start with the first part, learning about the social domain. Now India's transformation, as the name says, transformation. Matlab, can I say changes aa raha tha? Yes. India's transformation is reflected in the social domain also. So the government is actively trying to reduce the social disparity and to bring all the sections in the society into the mainstream of economic development. And that is why economic development in the mainstream, that is to be precise, yahan pe society mein everyone should be equally developed, obviously. Aisa nahi hona chahiye, the rich is getting more rich and the poor are getting more poorer. No. Everyone should be equal. But that doesn't mean ke ek socialist society bane ya communist society bane. No. We have to bring equality, and on the basis of that equality, their rights should be given. And that is why in this particular regard, the Human Rights Protection Act 1993 is important. National Human Rights Commission was established under this act. Now, what was the reason behind it? Because obviously every person is entitled for their own fundamental rights. Barabar? So, like the rights to life, right to equality, and to see that nobody is deprived of these rights. According to this act, the commission can act on the basis of a report of a case of deprivation of fundamental human rights. Now, what is fundamental human rights? The basic human rights published in the newspaper or other, which is also called as sui moto cognizance. Now, what is this other media? So, wo time pe a complaint can be launched by a social activist or a social institute on behalf of the victim. Like in 2005, the Domestic Violence Act was passed. This act was formed to provide protection to women from domestic violence. And that is why gharelu hinsa rokne ke liye ye start kiya tha. The most important provision in this act is the right of a woman on the house where she has been residing, even if she doesn't own the house. That is why yahan pe wo right diya gaya tha, specially by this period. According to the 2011 census, the sex ratio in India, that is female to male ratio, the ratio of girls is very low. In the age group of 0 to 6 years, and the number of girls is 914 against 1000 boys. So 914 girls ke samne 1000 boys. So obviously the statistics were basically warning us. Warning for what? For a grim of social situation. And several women organization raised their voice expressing a concern. Why? Because there were so many issues that were there related to women. Like for example, girl child born hota tha to wo time pe maar dete the. And wo jo orthodox mentality tha wo nikalna tha. Aaj bhi agar dekhe, bahut sare aise gaon the jahan pe till like a decade ago, bahut sare aise gaon hai jahan pe hum logon ne ye cheez notice kiya tha, witness kiya tha. But later on, the central government and the state government of India, of Maharashtra obviously, central government of India, they banned sex or gender prediction. द टेस्ट ऑफ द फीटस, मतलब बॉर्न होने से पहले जब ही वो चेक करते हैं कि लड़का है या लड़की, अगर लड़की है तो मार देते हैं वूम के अंदर ही, एंड दैट वॉज रॉन्ग, एंड वो उधर ही हम लोगों ने स्टॉप करवा दिया, दैट इज द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट ऑफ महाराष्ट्र. वो टाइम पे द टेस्ट ऑफ फीटस वॉज टोटली, द प्रिडिक्शन वॉज टोटली बैंड, एंड लॉन्च अ प्रोग्राम, प्रोग्राम का नाम था लेक लड़की और लेक लड़की. Gradually, the social loathing of birth of a girl is diminishing because of growing awareness. It is coming down. And iske liye, ye slowly and gradually changes aate gaya, not only in Maharashtra, but at country level. The next part that we are going to learn is about health. Now, health ke related, hum logo ne dekha tha, ki bahut saare aise, India mein, there was one such concern which was there for so many years, and that was polio. Polio eradication program was one of the greatest challenge for the central government as well as the state governments of different states. Now, the time came when the transformation came across there as well. The transformation of India was bound to reflect in the field of health. In 1995, the Health Department of Indian government launched a campaign dubbed as Pulse Polio Organization or Pulse Polio Campaign. Now, what was it all about? जब ये पल्स पोलियो कैंपेन चालू हुआ था, इट वॉज जॉइंटली स्टार्टेड अंडर द स्पॉन्सरशिप ऑफ वर्ल्ड हेल्थ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. तुम लोगों ने ये कोट सुना रहेगा या एडवर्टीजमेंट देखा रहेगा, अमिताभ बच्चन जी आते हैं एंड ही सेज इन हिज वॉइस, दो बूंद जिंदगी के. सो वॉट इज इट ऑल अबाउट? इट इज बेसिकली इरेडिकेशन के लिए, पल्स पोलियो इरेडिकेशन के लिए था, एंड बेसिकली अवेयरनेस के लिए था दैट दोज दैट पर्टिकुलर दो बूंद जिंदगी के इज वेरी मच नेसेसरी. इसके लिए वर्ल्ड हेल्थ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन के साथ अपने इंडियन गवर्नमेंट ने अलॉन्ग विथ यूनिसेफ, रोटरी इंटरनेशनल एंड गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया, दिस कैंपेन वॉज रन विथ अ डिटर्मिनेशन नॉट टू लीव अ सिंगल चाइल्ड अंडर द एज ऑफ 5 years विथाउट एडमिनिस्टरिंग द पोलियो वैक्सीनेशन. That is why various means were used to make the campaign absolutely successful, such as awareness camps were made, home visits were made, extensive advertising was done through various media. And jaise maine bola, Amitabh Bachchan ji ka wo advertisement do boon zindagi ke, so that became one of the trademark, right? So that basically brought across a change, and since last 2 years I would say, or 3 years, no, actually since 2019 and 18, that was the last time, and that was a year jab hi apne India se, and it is a proud moment for us when polio was totally eradicated, it was totally removed. So kudos to you all and for our government. Next part that we are going to learn is Ayush. Now, the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare of the Government of India opened a new developmental program or department for developing alternate medicines. Like for example, Ayurveda, Yoga, Naturopathy, Unani Medicine, Homeopathy, etc. And this was started since 2009. This department is known as Department of Ayurveda, Yoga, Naturopathy, Unani Medicine, Siddha and Homeopathy, together called as AYUSH, Ayush. Now, Ayush was started and it is still working for the development of the syllabi and education of these branches of medicine. Advanced research, standardization of medicine was done through this Ayush. And honestly speaking, bahut sare changes aaye the when we see that, arey yaar, hum log bimar hue, kya kiya? To wo goli kha liya hum logon ne. एक गोली खा ली हम लोगों ने, वो डॉक्टर के पास गए, उसने कोई गोली दे दी हम लोगों को, बट वो क्या है, वो एलोपैथी है. बट उसके अलावा भी बहुत सारे ऐसे तरीके हैं जिसके थ्रू हम लोग अपने आप को क्योर कर सकते हैं, एंड दीज आर द मेथड्स, लाइक फॉर एग्जांपल आयुर्वेदा, लाइक फॉर एग्जांपल योगा, लाइक फॉर एग्जांपल उनानी मेडिसिन, लाइक फॉर एग्जांपल नेचुरोपैथी, लाइक होम्योपैथी, लाइक सिद्ध, ऑल दीज आर डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ मेडिसिन जहां पे हम लोग ये अपने आप को क्योर कर सकते हैं. This is basically in one particular field, that is with respect to health. Now we are going to learn about the next part, that is learning about environment. Now, what is it all about? Why is environment important? Hum log school mein bhi ye subjects padhte hai, that is with respect to environment. Most of the states in India as well are facing the problem of increasing air pollution. The pollution caused by automobiles is an issue of great worry. The Center for Science and Environment studied the problem of pollution in Delhi and made the पब्लिक अवेयर ऑफ द सिवियोरिटी. वाई वाई सिवियोरिटी जरूरी था, मतलब वो सीरियसनेस लोगों को पता चला आना जरूरी था कि पॉल्यूशन की वजह से वॉट इज द आफ्टर इफेक्ट, वॉट इज द कॉन्सिक्वेंस ऑफ दैट, उसकी वजह से क्या क्या चीज हम लोग झेल रहे हैं. सो बिकॉज अनइवन रेन आता है, अचानक से टेम्परेचर 40 के अबाउ 45 के अबाउ दिल्ली ने विटनेस करना चालू किया, अनइवन रेन्स आता है, कोई भी महीने में कोई भी सीजन में रेन्स आ जाता था. सो दिस वॉज अ काइंड ऑफ थिंग दैट ब्रॉट अक्रॉस एंड दैट वॉज एक्सपीरियंस्ड बाई द पीपल ऑफ दिल्ली, एंड उनको रियलाइज होना चालू हुआ यार दिस हैज बिकम वन ऑफ द ग्रेटेस्ट कॉज ऑफ ऑल दीज डिफरेंट फैक्टर्स, दैट इज द ग्रेटेस्ट कॉज इज पॉल्यूशन. The pollution in Delhi is basically increasing number of automobile because of the increasing number of automobile vehicles with poor maintenance running on the street. So that cause of emission containing poisonous gases and carbon particles, the heritage monuments in Delhi are also getting affected because of this pollution. The heritage monuments in Delhi are also getting affected because of this pollution. The institution recommended here the use of different kinds of CNG, that is compressed natural gas, as fuel for vehicles to overcome the pollution problem. Based on this recommendation, the Supreme Court issued an order of using CNG for public transport vehicles as well in 1998. But later the policy of permitting only those vehicles as roadworthy which passed the PUC, that is pollution under control test. And this was adopted for every vehicle. And इसके लिए आज भी हम लोग जब भी रस्ते में जाते हैं एंड अगर किसी पुलिस वाले ने हमें रोका तो दे आस्क फॉर पेपर्स ऑफ द व्हीकल दैट वी हैव एंड दे आस्क फॉर PUC. अभी ये PUC के लेने का मतलब क्या है? इज योर व्हीकल एक्चुअली कंट्रोलिंग योर पॉल्यूशन? मतलब कंट्रोल मतलब क्या? मतलब वो कार्बन मोनोऑक्साइड कुछ ज्यादा तो नहीं फेंक रहा? And that is one of the main reason why a PUC certificate is required. And this, it was decided that vehicles without PUC certificate will not qualify for insurance as well and renewal of insurance also. So several centers issuing PUC certificate were opened. Chemical effluents drained into rivers and streams is the major source of water pollution. Efforts of a number of environment activists have contributed significantly to the environment conservation and preservation. Among them were Sundarlal Bahuguna with his own movement, that is Chipko movement, Medha Patkar with Narmada Bachao Andolan, Dr. Rajendra Singh with water conservation, and some prominent names. The pollution and food is increasing because of artificial and non-biodegradable materials like plastics and pesticides. This is also causing degradation. And ye cheez ki wajah se apne jo monuments hai, like for example Taj Mahal peela hote ja raha hai. Kyun? Because of the wastage that is caused, like biodegradable materials hai, like bahut sare uske aaju baju ke chemical industries hai jahan pe wo log jo waste hai, chemical waste, wo pani mein baha dete hai. Because of that bahut sara jo gases nikalta hai wo atmosphere ke sath milke Taj Mahal ka color येलो करते जा रहा है. सो दिस इज ऑल्सो कॉजिंग द डिग्रेडेशन ऑफ द सॉइल. इट कॉजेज अ स्पर्ट ऑफ वेरियस डिसीजेस इन ह्यूमंस, एनिमल्स एंड प्लांट्स दैट क्रिएट्स अ हार्मफुल सिचुएशन फॉर जनरल हेल्थ. फाइनली थ्री एक्सपेरिमेंट्स इन महाराष्ट्र इन द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ कंजर्वेशन एंड प्रिजर्वेशन ऑफ एनवायरमेंट आर इंडीड वर्दी ऑफ मेंशन. तो ये कौन से है? लेट अस स्टार्ट, स्टार्टिंग विद द फर्स्ट एक्सपेरिमेंट, रही बाय पोपेरे. Now, on 8th of March 2018, Rahibai Popere was felicitated by the President of India by Nari Shakti Award. This award was given for her work in Kalsubai Parisar Biyani Samvardhan Samiti, and she is popularly known as Bij Mata, that is the Seed Mother. She has worked for preserving the seeds of native cultivators for the future generation, and that is one of the main reason why her grandson got matlab wo chalu kabhi hua, her grandson got ill because of the diet consisting of food made of hybrid varieties of food grains and vegetables of lesser quality. So hybrid matlab mixture quality, jabhi mixture hua to wo time pe it became a difficult task. She thought of native varieties of food grains to overcome the problem, and she decided to grow the food, grains and vegetables of native variety to meet her family's need. She began to do it and store the seeds of those jitne bhi land races the, jaise deshi one the, bitter gourd, या फिर दैट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज करले स्पिनच दैट इज पालक. अमरंथूस ट्राइकलर दैट इज तांदूळजा लालमठ. स्वीट बीन्स हियासिंथ बीन्स पावट. बिटर बीन्स ट्विस्टेड बीन्स काडुवल. केवड दैट इज किडनी बीन्स. ग्राउंडनट भुईमूग. ऑल्सो बार्नयार्ड मिलेट वरई. वराइटीज ऑफ राइस धावल बाट कालबाट आंबामोर and black gram that is udit. She did not confine her efforts only to her family but through micro banking groups. मतलब जितने भी seeds थे ये सब उनको वो जमा करते थे and उसको reproduce करके और seeds जमा करते थे. अच्छा वो खुद करते थे तो लोगों ने देखा कि ये हो रहा है तो दूसरे groups settle करना चालू किए and there started a movement. Movement started by her grew well with the partnership of Bharatiya Agro Industries Foundation also called as BAIF. Rahibai preserved the seeds in the earthen pots. Once filled, she closes the pot by plastering its mouth by mixture of soil and cow dung. Matlab wo jab hi kar liya, so that is the greatest thing. So this method saves the seeds from insects also and ants also. Before closing the pot, the seeds are covered with a layer of ash and neem leaves. And now in her seed bank, she has collection of somewhere around more than 50 land races of food grains. Now, 50 land races is a very big thing and 30 land races of vegetables. She is one of the three Indian women selected as Women of the Year 2018 by BBC among 100 women from various countries. Next, jiske baare mein hum log padhne wale hai, that is Bhav Kaddare. Now, Bhav Kaddare and his associate work for the conservation of nature through an institute called as Sahyadri Nisarg Mitra. In 1999, Bhav Kaddare read about the white-breasted sea eagle and as an endangered species, abhi ye ek aisa tha, he began his work in Ratnagiri district to save and conserve this bird. It all started for saving that particular bird. Jaise hum logon ne Rahibai Popere ka dekha tha that she started saving the land races of the food grains. Matlab jo uska DNA basically tha wo. And here Bhav Kaddare, he started matlab unhone ek initiative liya tha for protecting this white-breasted sea eagle. Now, he began his work in Ratnagiri, but he created public awareness about this bird by trekking the sea coast of this district. In this, he found out 62 nesting sites of this bird. While doing this, he and his associated, jitne bhi uske associates the, they detected some instances of smuggling of the nest of birds known as Indian swiftlets. Yes, you can see this. And they are also called as Pakoli at Bandra Island, which is located near Vengurla Rocks in the vicinity of Nivati Port in Sindhudurg district. It's not Mumbai wala Bandra nahi hai. The nests were smuggled out and sold in foreign countries. There was a need to save these birds and their nests. Sahyadri Nisarg Mitra worked in that direction. As a result of this, Indian swiftlets were included in Schedule 1, that is A list of wildlife. Offense against which it is punishable, that is of the Wildlife Protection Act 1972, and that was one of the remarkable contribution of Sahyadri Nisarg Mitra. The next Sahyadri Nisarg Mitra ka jo main association ka jo purpose tha wo to ek bird se chalu hua tha, but it continued with other, like for example Sahyadri Nisarg Mitra also worked for the protection of olive ridley turtles. Yes, the female of this species come to Vela's beach, that is Ratnagiri district, for nesting. Bhav Kaddare and his associates, they planned an operation for the protection of these nests. So in the first year, they were successful in protecting 50 nests. 50 nests protect kar liya. 2,734 baby turtles from these nests, they were successfully released back into the sea, and that was so amusing, that was so wonderful. This proved to be a start of an annual event, and waha se chalu hua turtle festival. Hundreds of tourists come every year to watch the occasion of these baby turtles returning to the sea. Just returning, matlab wo dekhne ka, it is so nice to see. to accommodate them, facilities for homestay were even developed for these tourists, and the peasants were trained for the management of homestay. Thus, efforts for conservation of nature resulted into development of tourism in that area. Can you imagine? मतलब खाली एक conservation का एक खाली एक छोटा सा मुहिम start किया था, which resulted into a great tourism industry. The news of this development was well appreciated in Maharashtra. Now, Bhau Kadare and his associates are working for the protection of endangered pangolin, anteater that is also called as Khawalya Manzar. Moving forward with the next part, that is next person, Prem Sagar Mistry. The number of vultures is rapidly decreasing in India. So, for protecting these vultures, vultures are basically scavengers in the nature. Two species of vulture, that is long-billed vulture and white-back vultures, are observed in this region around Raigad. Prem Sagar Mistry and his associates are basically working for increasing their number and to make available safe food for them through Society for Eco-Endangered Species Conservation and Protection, also called as SEESCAP, a non-governmental organization, NGO. The painkillers, that is a drug called as diclofenac, given to the animals has proved to be toxic for vultures. And besides, dearth of trees with adequate height, scarcity of food have also caused the decrease of vulture population. So basically, the people working for CSCAP are gradually getting success in changing these circumstances. Dear students, we'll be meeting in the next video. We'll be moving forward in the next video through education. Till then, dear students, stay home, stay safe. Do follow the other videos of the YouTube channel as well, to my YouTube channel as well. Till then, stay home, stay safe. Sambhal ke raho, guys. Bye-bye.